We don't often think of blood groups when choosing a spouse, but differences in blood groups can lead to complications. Specifically, these problems can occur during pregnancy and put the unborn child at risk. Thus, understanding blood group systems that we use is important. The ABO blood group system and the RH system are the two most common, but there are about 30 other blood group systems too. The ABO system is based on the presence or absence of antigen A or B on the surface of your red blood cells. An antigen is a molecule that triggers an immune response. If you have the A blood group, your red blood cells have the antigen A, and vice versa for the B blood group. But what if your blood group is AB or O? The AB blood group indicates that you have both antigens A and B, whereas the O blood group indicates that you have neither of them. If your blood group is A, your body will identify B blood group cells as foreign particles and form antibodies against those B cells. In the same way, those with B blood will produce antibodies against A blood group cells. These antibodies trigger an immune reaction when they encounter their respective antigens. The immune reaction can be severe and even lead to death. Those with AB blood group do not produce antibodies against either antigen, so any other blood group can transfuse blood to an AB blood group individual, which is why they're called universal acceptors. On the other hand, O blood group individuals will produce antibodies against both A and B antigens. However, since those with O blood group have neither A nor B antigens, they can donate blood to people with other blood groups, and are therefore called universal donors. Even though a difference in blood groups does not affect every couple, it could become a problem when conceiving a child. The differences in the ABO system are not a major concern, but the same cannot be said for the RH blood group system. RH incompatibility is a real problem, one that can affect both mother and child. RH incompatibility can occur when the mother is RH negative and the fetus is RH positive. If the fetal blood, which is RH positive, leaks into the maternal circulation, which has RH negative blood, fetal cells will be recognized as foreign. This results in the mother producing antibodies called RH immunoglobulin G. These antibodies could pass through the mother's placenta and attack the fetus's red blood cells. Once the red blood cells break down, they produce bilirubin, which causes the child to be jaundiced. Hydration and phototherapy using bilirubin lights can treat jaundice. Bilirubin lights, emitting rays of 420 to 470 nanometers, convert bilirubin into a form that can easily be excreted from the body. In the worst case scenario, the baby might have to undergo a blood transfusion while still in the uterus. Even if the treatment options can give positive results, prevention is still a better option, and much easier than the difficulties faced during the treatment. So, speak with your partner about blood group issues and possible complications. Furthermore, advances in the commercial production of antibodies have helped to reduce drug costs and increase their availability. This has opened up many possibilities for couples who want to avoid any problems during their pregnancy.